It's good to have you with us on this Monday. And I want to go to a psalm that has been such a blessing to me. And it's a very convicting psalm, but it's also a very encouraging psalm. So often we find ourselves being a little bit discouraged or down. And as I've mentioned in several other of these times together, that a problem within can cause that. We read in Psalm 51, verse 8, "Make me to hear joy and gladness." And then we read in verse 12, "Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit." Now, as you might probably know, this psalm is about David's sin and how he had grieved the Lord, and now he's making a full confession of that sin, and then showing his trust not only in forgiveness, but in restoration to usefulness. And that is what I want to focus on here. I trust that each day you are very honest with the Lord about the needs in your life. There's nothing worse than unconfessed sin. But when sin does come, in fact, verse 8, the second part of the verse says, "that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice." In other words, when we sin, there's just a reaction in our soul. Our conscience is quickened and God works. And sometimes God has to do other things to get our attention. And so once that gets settled, there's a great joy of having a clean conscience. But there can very much still be a sense of, I sinned, what's the use? And a discouragement can set in. You know you're right with God, but there's still a darkness, and that ought not be. That's a focus on self. I find that we understand the fact that there is no penance for us to have shorter time in purgatory. We know that as believers. But I think Satan is able to get to us and cause us to think that we've got to go through a dark, discouraged time and somehow pay for our sin, even though we've confessed it. And finally, we'll get to a place where God can give us joy back. Well, we do need to grieve over our sin. And we do need to understand there are consequences for our sin. But we also need to remember that when He forgives us, He forgives us. And that the Spirit of God indwells us. We can't earn anything. We cannot earn God's forgiveness. You couldn't do it for salvation. You can't do it for your Christian life. We have to understand that it's all of God. Now, we need to respond with deep repentance to the Lord. But once we have, even though there may be some grief that continues on, we can have the Spirit of God give us supernatural joy, take the clouds away, and cause us to really be used of Him. As I mentioned in verse 12, "Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit," with thy spirit. "Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee." I'll tell you, one of the best things you can do after you truly get right with God is to let the Spirit of God have control, rejoice in God's goodness, quit looking at yourself and letting Satan cause darkness to come, and then begin to serve the Lord. If you wait and wait and wait to serve the Lord till you feel better, you may never feel better. The point is, there's the joy of God's Spirit causing His power to flow through us. So I want to encourage you today, here on this Monday, you might be a little bit feeling discouraged about yourself. Make sure you're fully right with God, and then claim the joy of the Lord, and start letting God use you to be a blessing again.